When new computer technologies are introduced, a number of issues need to be considered in addition to the technical feasibility of any solution. These include ethical, privacy, legal, environmental, and cultural issues. In this video, we take a brief look at privacy issues of computer science. The rise of computer technology has caused some to question the implications for individuals' privacy. Cameras and surveillance systems have perfected number plate and face recognition so that people can easily be tracked. There are clear benefits such as crime prevention, but it's also open to misuse. Electronic tagging can identify where convicted criminals are with GPS tracking. Black boxes in cars can monitor how people drive for insurance and accident investigation purposes. Mobile phone signals can be tracked, which also allows technology such as Find My iPhone to enable you to find a lost phone or tablet. In addition, GPS technology is used to automatically tag date, time, and location where photographs are taken. And social networking tools allow this data to easily be shared with friends and family. Schools will monitor internet and computer activity of their students, and this logging also extends to the workplace, where work patterns and phone calls are routinely recorded. Modern browsers record a history of sites visited and have options to retain passwords and credit card details to make browsing easier. This may give rise to piracy issues if other computer users access this data. Big data and data mining is slightly outside the scope of the course, but is fascinating. It's a process of looking for patterns and trends from very large data sets, which can be used to make strategic business decisions as well as targeting advertising. Data is now a very valuable commodity. There are therefore many avenues to explore when considering privacy. Sir Tim Berners-Lee, inventor of the World Wide Web, criticised moves by legislators in the UK and the US, which he saw as an assault on the privacy of web users. He has criticised the UK's Investigatory Powers Act, saying that the idea that all ISPs should be required to spy on citizens and hold the data for 6 months is appalling. In the United States, he is concerned that the principle of net neutrality, which treats all internet traffic equally, could be watered down by the Trump administration and the Federal Communications Commission. The web's creator also said he was shocked by the direction the US Congress and Senate had taken when they voted to scrap laws preventing internet service providers from selling users' data. He said privacy online was as important as the trust between a doctor and a patient. "We're talking about a human right. My ability to communicate with people on the web and to go to websites I want without being spied on. It's really, really crucial." An increasing range of smart devices in our homes are voice activated, and they're capable of listening in on our daily activities. Some people argue that the government are collecting valuable information for counter-terrorism operations using this technology. So should smart devices be allowed to continually record and listen? The arguments for state that data encryption makes information private. Voice input obviously is convenient and may help some disabled users. Intelligence information has the ability to save lives. And if you have nothing to hide, then privacy shouldn't be an issue. Arguments against obviously state everyone is entitled to their privacy. The TV may also be able to take pictures, and the TV may be logging data to be used for other purposes. So a quick recap of the ways in which computer systems may cause privacy issues include number plate recognition, face recognition, electronic tagging, cell phone location and GPS technology, recording internet browsing history, retention of personal data, and smart listening devices, just to name a few.